aquatic ecosystems. So this ecosystem deals with water bodies and its biotic communities. There are two types of ecosystems. First is freshwater ecosystem. Next is seawater. So first is freshwater ecosystem. What is freshwater ecosystem? This is a subset of Earth's aquatic ecosystem. Limnology is a study about freshwater ecosystem, and it's a part of hydrobiology. Now, freshwater habitat means of four things comes under this habitat. First is temperature, light penetration, nutrients, and also vegetation. So there are two types of freshwater ecosystem. First is lentic type. Second is lenotic type. Under lentic type, pond ecosystem and lake ecosystem comes. Stream and river comes under the second type, which is also called as a lenotic type of ecosystem. So first, let's see the lentic type, where pond and lake ecosystem comes. A biological system that includes water and plant life interacting with each other. Now, it is a self-regulating and self-sufficient ecosystem, and fresh water is still here or it is stagnant here. There are three types or three regions in this ecosystem. First is littoral, next is limnetic, next is profundus. What is littoral region? Littoral region is where the surface of water with sunlight. Second is limnetic region, which is where the sunlight penetrates into the less deep water, and profundus means there is no sunlight in the deep region. These are the three areas of pond ecosystem. First one is stream ecosystem. Stream is something which flows through a forest, and its clear water will rush over the rocks and into deep pools. The stream is the home to many plants and organisms. Now, there are three types of streams. First is intermittent stream, perennial stream, and ephemeral stream. Now, what is perennial stream? Water flows in these streams throughout the year. The primary water source can be from groundwater, surface water, or it can be a combination of both. Next is intermittent stream. Intermittent streams flow for part or most of the year, but they may carry no water during the dry season. Next is ephemeral stream. Now, these streams flow only for a short time, which is after a large storm or snow melt when there is an increase in water runoff. Ephemeral streams are very small and they are normally have a dry channel during the year. Now let's see the benefits of streams. A stream looks great in any park or backyard, but stream benefits extend beyond aesthetics. The water, even in the form of a small stream, can increase the poverty value of community and homes. This is the main benefit of stream. Next is river ecosystem. River water comes under the lotic ecosystem. Now, the water drains into the landscape, and this includes biotic as well as abiotic components and physical and chemical they are part of large watershed catchments where headwater streams drain into the mid-sized streams. The river ecosystem includes unidirectional flowing water, which is the water flows in just one direction. Continuous physical change, then changing micro habits, and then variability in the flow rate of water. There are components of freshwater ecosystem. There are abiotic factors and biotic factors. Abiotic factors are the factors which include non-living things, and Biotic is where it includes the living organism. Abiotic factors are light, water, temperature, organic and inorganic components like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur and calcium, and also carbohydrates, proteins, lipids. Amount of water present at the pond is called as standing grid. Biotic factors produces, consumers, decomposes. Decomposers are also called as micro consumers. So first, let's see producers. Producers includes phytoplankton, phytoplankton includes large plants like Salvinia, Wolffia, Azolla, Pistia. Consumers, there are three types of consumers. First is primary consumers, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers. Under primary consumers, zooplankton, worms, herbivores, and also crabs come under this consumer. Secondary type of consumers, insects and small fish. Tertiary consumers, it includes big fish, cranes, and hawks. The decomposers, it includes bacteria, fungi like Phycium and
Aspergillus and Phycium. Surekha, are you there?
Hi, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We'll go to the next slide.
Yeah, ma'am. So the next type of ecosystem is marine water ecosystem. Now, marine ecosystems are the largest of Earth's ecosystem, and they are distinguished by waters that have high salt content. Sea water comes under this type of ecosystem. Now, these ecosystems contrast with freshwater ecosystem, which has a lower salt content. Now, there are types of marine water ecosystem. First is salt marsh, mangroves, intertidal zones, lagoons, estuaries, coral reef, deep sea and sea floor. Ocean ecosystem, which is also called as a marine ecosystem. Now, oceans are the major sinks of carbon dioxide, regulating biochemical cycles, hydrological cycles for the Earth's climate. There are two major life zones: coastal zone and open sea. Under coastal zone, they are rich nutrient shallow water, and they also yield a high productivity. Open sea is deeper part of the ocean. Now, we have abiotic factors and biotic factors under this type of ecosystem also. Abiotic factors include salt, organic, inorganic compounds, oxygen, light, temperature, tides and waves. Biotic factors, first is producers, second consumers, third is decomposers. Now, first is producers. Under producers, phytoplankton, algae, angel sperm, grasses, mangrove plants. Consumers consist of three types of consumers, first is primary, secondary and tertiary. Under primary consumers, small fish, crabs and prawns. Secondary consumers are big fishes like herring, shark and mackerel. Tertiary consumers consist of very big fishes like cod and haddock. Decomposers are generally bacteria and fungus. Estuaries are present at the mouth of a river where fresh water and sea water mix. Now, mixing of fresh and sea water will help the producers and the ecosystem to get more nutrients. And organisms show wide range of tolerance to salinity, temperature, as there are variations in stream flow and tidal currents. are biotic and abiotic factors here. Abiotic factors are the salt, organic and inorganic compounds. Biotic factors are macrophytes and microphytes. Then we have phytoplankton. Estuaries, they provide more food for man and organisms, and therefore they need to be protected.